This is why the Prophet, peace be upon him, says, nikah must be in the masjid, open for everybody to attend. There is no restriction of entry here. Why? Because everyone comes, they can sit and watch, get a reminder, and at the same time they can think to themselves, you know what, I need to resolve my own problems. I need to make myself a person who can learn a lesson from this, go home and say, look, I'm sorry, I'm really, really, very sorry. You know, we don't want it like the imam in the masjid, he said, when you go home, I'm sure you've heard this from me before, you need to make sure you praise the cooking of your wife. She's been working so hard in the kitchen. She's actually been there for so long. And whatever she cooks, when last did you say, wow, what a meal, subhanAllah, what a meal. Today I received an email where somebody said, and I'm sure you must have seen it, it's been doing its rounds for a few years. They say the son was watching his father when the mother had burnt the toast. And he came in and he didn't even notice that the toast was burnt. He didn't even notice. He ate it and he said, wow, it was such a lovely meal. And later on, when they were going to sleep, the son goes to the father and says, Dad, do you really like burnt toast? Because he uttered the comment, I love burnt toast, you know, this type of toast. Do you really like burnt toast? So the father calls his son close. He says, listen, son, burnt toast doesn't hurt anyone. But what you say from your mouth can be very hurtful. Look at the comment. The burnt toast doesn't hurt anyone. Don't. What you said from your mouth can be very hurtful. So just say, I love it. I like it. The only thing is, just tell them tomorrow I opt for something else. Because then they'll get that for you every day. So I will say that the imam says, go home and praise the cooking of your wife. A man comes home and he praises the cooking. Wow, lovely dish. Oh, I've never tasted the dish. And the wife gives him the pan on his head. Boom, one shot. Oh, what happened here? She says, for 23 years I've been cooking for you. You've never praised my food. Today when the food came from the neighbors, you're praising it. You're praising it. So then he had to explain himself, look, I'm very sorry, it wasn't meant to be, and so on and so forth. So let us not praise the cooking of our wives 23 years down the line. You know, there is a lot of sacrifice that goes into that. And even if there is a little bit more, a pinch of salt and so on, so what? As we said, the words mean a lot. May the Almighty grant us goodness and help us. Inshallah, in a few moments we will hear the officiation of the nikah. May I call you forward. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina.